Hello and welcome to USB to Amiga, a device that you can use to connect USB input devices to an Amiga. Why did I do this? Well, during Corona, I got to move to home office, and for this home office, I wanted to have a beautiful retro machine, and I decided to go for a Commodore CD-TV. This is practically an Amiga with a CD-ROM in the, built in that looks like an audio CD player. The restoration worked out quite well, so now I've got a machine with 8 megabytes of fast RAM, an EDE connector, and an Amiga OS 3.1.4 installed. But there's one big problem. The keyboard costs about as much as the machine costs. So the alternative would be to buy an adapter. But there is no adapter you can buy. So, like every good evil overlord, you have to do it yourself. So that's what I did. I built an adapter. The hardware you need to do this. You need an USB host shield, an Arduino Pro Micro, some pin headers, matching connectors. Matching means matching to the Amiga you're using. You need a serial interface for programming, so something that converts USB to the TTL level UART, and you need some level shifters that convert the 3.3 volt to the 5 volt used by the Amiga. So let me put some thoughts on the level shifter. The Amiga architecture is 5 volt open collector. This means if you want to have to send a 0, you've put it to the ground. If you want to have it as 1, you leave it open or set it as an input. 5 volts for the Arduino can't be used because the USB host shield requires a power of 3.3 volt. And the specification says that driving the input with 5 volts would be too high. This does not apply for the mouse, right and middle buttons because these are potentiometers and they, if you try to route them through a level shifter, they won't even work. But I've then thought about, given some thought about it, and some great engineer came to mind stating that, forget it. A good engineer always is a wee bit conservative, at least on paper. Just bypass. It'll work. So how can you build one? Without the level shifters, it's really easy. You can do it just like Lego in 4 simple steps. In the first step, you take the USB host shield, then you solder in the pin headers for connecting. On this, you solder on the Arduino Pro Micro. And on top of it, you then connect the wires. This is one of the examples. This is what I use for my Amiga 2000. This is what I use for connecting my CD32. Up here, you can still see the lever shifter that has been soldered on it. But as you can see by nothing connected to the pins, I'm not using it. This is one of the first close to product that I got. This is for my CD-TV with level shifters, which is these. And this is the version that I'm having used and use right now. This is what I call the beast because it's really the full featured thing. It has the connectors for keyboard and mouse. This is a joystick input so that I can use it like the input, like a CD-TV remote. And there even is another small wire going out, but we'll be getting to this later on. So these are the variations that you can build. For the CD-TV, you need a mini DIN connector, for example. For the Amiga 2000 and 3000, you need a DIN 5 connector. The CD32 uses a mini DIN 6. The problem that I had I found in some forums that you can connect some remote keyboard interface to the Amiga 600 and 1200, but I never found any exact documentation. If you know something about that, contact me, I will put it in there. So these are this is the key mapping of the keys that aren't available on a PC keyboard. So for the left control of the Amiga, I'm using the right control for the PC, so any control key will work. The Amiga keys will be used with the Win keys and also the menu key in case you have got a keyboard with just one Win key. Then there's this very unique button close to the return button, return key, that states the hash and the carry sign on it. And there's also this key right of the shift key, of the left shift key, which has the smaller and greater signs on them, which is only on Dean keyboards. This is also available on an additional key, but you can also use the original ones. And also one thing that's quite nice is for the CDTV, you can also have a power key. So if you, like me, got a wireless keyboard, you can just lay back and turn it off very remote. So let's take a look at the input. The input comes in from a USB HID device or human interface device. This can be a keyboard, this can be a mouse, this can be one of those desktops, these keyboard mouse combos. But there's also some things that are not working. The USB hub should work, but it doesn't. The examples that are provided with the USB host shield contain some implementation for the host for the USB hub, but trying it with this some kind of setup, it didn't work for me. And what's also not working are the keyboard LEDs for the same reason. There is some code in there. It should work, but if I try the examples, it doesn't. And I also did some debugging, but could not get deep enough to really pinpoint the cause of the problem. And for the CDTV only, you can use a passive two-button joystick, a passive two-button joystick. On the output, what we are outputting is the Amiga protocol. Logically, every Amiga uses the same protocol. Only the Amiga 500 has a slightly different handling of the reset. Instead of using of pulling reset via the protocol, it is a separate pin. But this has also been implemented. The mouse protocol is also implemented, and the Amiga protocol and the CDTV protocol is implemented as well. This includes joysticks and the CDTV remote keys. Not every key is implemented, but they can be added rather easy. And now to those two extra wires. Connected to my CDTV, I've also got a GoTek drive with flash floppy firmware. And for this one, these two wires are connected to the next and pref buttons. So you can use the keyboard combos that you know from the flash floppy OSD hardware, so that you can use Control Alt left, right, and up for next pref and pressing both keys together. So this is rather quite interesting, also being laid back, swapping floppies. The configuration is done on compile time. There's one central config.h which holds all the configuration for one variation. Each variation comes with its own directory, and all the variations at the time that are of now, these are six, are available as precompiled hex files for flashing. And every variant has a different pin layout. So let's take a look. And everything is documented. Here's just a short example on how it's documented. comparing the pin layouts of the Amiga 2000 and the CDTV, we'll notice that only the keyboard connector is at the same place, and the connectors of the USB host shield is the same. These are really fixed. Everything else will float on how it should fit better for soldering. So, and if you want to compile and work with the software, everything is available on GitHub, and it is based on the upon a project called Microsoft Wireless Desktop to CDTV, and it's coded in Arduino C++, so it works with the Arduino IDE. Yes, this IDE sucks. It sucks big time, but it was done to keep the entry threshold low. You don't need the IDE. There also is a set of makefiles that allow you to compile every variant using a project called Arduino MK, which is some makefiles to include so that that you can compile Arduino code without the need for the IDE. The downside for you guys using Windows is that symlinks are required, because I can work against a crappy IDE and a crappy operating system, but I have to make some compromises. There are still some to-dos. I want to include PS2 support so that I can use the output for CD32 with a riser card, which in itself includes typically a PS2 to Amiga converter. And I need to do this because if you have both two keyboard controllers on the bus, it just won't work. I also want to fix somehow, if I know how, the USB hub support and LED support. I want to build and test an Amiga 500 setup. I'm also thinking about maybe designing a custom PCB so it looks more like a real product, but the Arduino Pro Mini and the USB host shield, if you buy them and solder them together, they will be still be cheaper. Just buying the chips alone and soldering them on the PC on a new PCB. So I'm not sure if this really makes sense. And what I want to do is I want to do a Kyomuro 128D or an SX64 version, so that those machines that have also detachable keyboards from the 8-bit area, that they also can be used with a USB keyboard. Either you've gotten one without the keyboard and need some replacement, or you just want to go for some more comfort, like having it wireless. So, and for my conclusion, there are a lot of people I have to thank for getting this project done. Starting with Imp from Leitstelle 511 in Hanover. He was showing me the USB host shield. He was the guy I could turn to and ask, you're doing a lot with keyboards, but I need keyboard input. Is there something you can show me? Yeah, no problem, there it is. And from there I could go myself. The Microsoft Wireless Desktop to CDTV code was done by Mattstaff at GitHub. Without him, I most probably would have given up in between and getting all the things to work. And he himself used Amiga keyboard code from HKZLab at GitHub. The Amiga mouse was implemented after reading an example done by CSSVB94 at GitHub. And I had one very faithful beta tester at the AK1 forum, at the A1K forum, Otifund011. And of course, I have to thank you for watching this and spreading the word that if you want to connect a USB device to an Amiga, you now can. Thank you for watching.